assessment coming into force. Essentially, what the immigration officers are going to do going forward is they will not issue a work permit longer than a four-year period. So essentially, the work permit will have a cap. Most work permits will have a cap for 4 years maximum, unless your occupation falls under the exemption code. But most occupations essentially will be 4 years max to get a work permit. And the reason why they're doing this is because the 4 years is essentially enough time for the employer either to look at training and hiring a Canadian for that same position, or possibly offering the foreign worker a permanent full-time position to the organization and continue with the PR application. Now, an example for this would be for, here's an example. Since April 1st, 2001, a tenured foreign worker has accumulated 3 years of work in Canada and now is applying for a two-year work permit and occupation and is not listed under the exemption. In this case scenario, the work permit will only be given an extension so long as you have all the necessary paperwork for one more year. If you're in this situation, you could either have a conversation with your employer to either offer you a full-time permanent position or possibly hiring and training a Canadian so that the company is not left hanging once your work permit expires. So keep that in mind, and really it's called the Temporary Foreign Worker Program, 4 year maximum cumulative duration. The other thing I wanted to mention, the 4 year work permit, let's say if you got a work permit for 2 years, there was a gap for 2-3 years, and then you had to apply again for the position for another 3 years, for example. So long as that gap is within that 4 year period. So an example would be 2011, you got a work permit for 3 years, and now, you know, there's a gap of 3 years and you wanted to apply for another 2 year work permit. Because 4 years have not elapsed, you'd be getting a 1 year work permit. But if 3 years have elapsed, if 4 years have elapsed, then you can get that full extension of that work permit again. So essentially that 4 year cap renews itself as well. I hope that clarifies in regards to how long you should ask for when you apply for a labor market impact assessment or for a regular work permit, because like I said, there is a 4 year cap. There is an exception category. There are certain occupations that are under the exception where that 4 year cap doesn't apply. Please watch that video to see if your occupation is on that list. Otherwise, you know that either you or your employer have to make some executive decision in regards to what's gonna happen after that 4 year cap. I hope this video helped. If you have any questions about how long you can ask for a work permit, give us a call. We're here to help. Thank you, and until next time.